شعبية الحبيب.
I will accept no new transitional phase and we will not step up from our role in the government that we promised the people until an election is held.
Murat Aslan is an assistant professor and a faculty member at the Sabah Dinzaim University, and he joins us now from here in Istanbul. It's always a pleasure to have you on the program. Now, we have two prime ministers, one that is currently being recognized by the UN and another that was appointed by parliament. Where is the situation headed to? There surely can't be two prime ministers leading a country.
Afnan Hanım, you know, very strange. And in the meantime, there has been a long but long term of quarrel between the political actors in Libya, just because of the elections that had to be, you know, realized on December 24th. And the new developments are actually a type of preparation for the next elections, even though the time is and the date is not fixed yet. And also the process is at large. That means we don't know what type of elections will be held, in what order, like selection of the president, constitution, parliament, still not clear. And now they are trying to prepare or shape the environment for another term, because there's a probability that there can't be any election in close future. So I think we should check exactly the dynamics in Libya, like the attitude of the armed groups, mainly at the West, and the outcomes mainly being shaped by Haftar and Akhila Saleh, because we know that the West is divided.
With the postponement of elections and political turmoil in the country, Libya hasn't been politically stable in recent time. What do you think will bring stability to the country?
Well, first, there must be a fixed process in terms of methodology, in terms of constitutional framework. That means they have to first vote for the constitution. And there must be something in their minds that they must be committed for a stable Libya. Once any of them, like armed groups, like political figures, like the external actors, doesn't matter, try to, you know, shape the future just for their own cause, like their political career or more benefit from the pie of Libya, I think they can find an excuse to stop everything. But
right.
If UNSMIL is in charge, I think UNSMIL must lead it as they did two years ago.
Okay, as you mentioned, there's a lot of factions in Libya who receive support from different regions of the country. Where and who is Fethi Bashagha getting his support from? And can we see the formation of an elected government?
A very good question. You know, Bashagha is from Misrata city, and he had fought against the Daesh cells inside the country and also established a type of special protection unit in Tripoli when he was a minister of interior. On the other hand, Dibaiba is also from Misrata. And this move, I mean, selecting Bashagha, will balance, you know, both actors in Misrata. That means another division in one of the most stronger states in Libya. So now, Haftar actually just threw out a stone, and he will have two birds. One thing, the West will be divided. Another thing, the Misrata will be divided, and that's one of the most important things, I believe.
All right, Professor Murat Aslan, it's always a pleasure having you here on the NewsHour. Thank you for that analysis.